As you can see, this is a beautiful lake. The area of this lake is approximately 63,886 meters square. Now let us obtain the evaporation of this lake using an empirical formula. We will be using the Meyer's formula to obtain its evaporation. First of all, according to Dalton's law of evaporation, the rate of evaporation is proportional to the difference between the saturated vapor pressure and actual vapor pressure. We will need wind velocity at 9 meters height. We will need saturation vapor pressure, which was 20.96 millimeters of mercury yesterday. Relative humidity was 60%. So the actual vapor pressure is equal to relative humidity multiplied by saturation vapor pressure. So the value of actual vapor pressure will be 12.57 millimeters of mercury. Now, the Meyer's formula is evaporation is equal to K, which is a constant, multiplied by EW minus EA, difference between saturation vapor pressure and actual vapor pressure, multiplied by 1 plus U9 by 16. U9 is the wind velocity, mean monthly wind velocity at 9 meters height. Now, the value of the constant for this lake, well, for most of the lakes, it is taken as 0.36. EW is 20.96, EA is 12.57, U9 wind velocity was 10 kilometers per hour. So the value of lake evaporation using Meyer's formula was 4.90 millimeters yesterday. We used the data of the nearest weather station to obtain the evaporation. Now, if this evaporation value in millimeters is multiplied with the area, which is 63886 meters square, you will get the volume of water evaporated. It was equal to 313.04 meter cube. Thank you.